the legendary Russian Lira class submarine of Project 705, NATO codename Alpha, is one of the most prominent combat vehicles of the Soviet Union during the Cold War, as well as the Russian Navy in the later period. In the late 1960s, the Soviet Union began to produce a new generation of Project 705 Lira nuclear submarines, which possessed a number of unique features, such as a titanium hull and a reactor with liquid metal coolant. These special nuclear submarines gradually built a reputation, becoming a legend in the eyes of the public and Western observers. Lira-class submarines were even featured in the movies. They appear in the famous American writer Tom Clancy's military fantasy film, The Hunter for Red October. Books about the super-secret Soviet nuclear submarine also sold well in the West. There was a reason for this, mainly because these boats carried the very innovative technologies of the time. Soviet nuclear power attack submarines tended to be faster and deeper diving than their Western counterparts, though they were also noisier and more prone to horrifying accidents. The Project 705 originated as a 1958 design concept to push the speed advance to the maximum, allowing the submarine not only keep pace with but overtake NATO carrier task forces, typically cruising at 33 knots, while keeping one step ahead of enemy torpedoes and outmaneuvering enemy submarines. A single reactor and turbine plane driving the boat at the phenomenal 42 knots underwater. Reactor's power could be rapidly increased, as well as the submarine's speed. This extraordinary performance could be achieved by ruthlessly maximizing speed and subtracting from weight. Thus, the Alpha featured a relatively small hull made of titanium alloy. Titanium is a rare metal which can create surfaces as strong as steel for roughly half the weight. It is also permagnetic, making the submarine's hull more difficult to detect from maritime patrol planes using magnetic anomaly detectors. The resulting Project 705 submarine measured 81 meters long, but weighed only 3,200 tons submerged. For comparison, the 84-meter long American Pyramid-class submarine displaced 4,800 tons submerged. The Project 705 Lira looked the part with sphere teardrop-shaped hull, ruggedly streamed out sail designed to minimize aquadynamic drag, and even its convertible-style pop-up windshield. The Alpha featured a typical Soviet double hull configuration, but only one of its six internal compartments were intended for habitation by the crew. Extraordinary degrees of automation allowed a complement of 15 officers cooped together in the heavily protected third compartment of the vessel, instead of the roughly 100 personnel typical on the contemporary SSNs. Each Project 705 carried 18 to 20 533mm torpedoes, which could be automatically loaded into six tubes, which could pneumatically pop the weapons upwards to engage ships overhead. Optionally, RPK-2 Starfish nuclear anti-submarine missiles and ultra-fast Scud super-cavitating torpedoes could also be carried. Alpha variants armed with ballistic missiles or gigantic 650mm torpedo tubes were conceived, but never built. After spending 9 years in development, four Alphas were let out in Sverdlovsk and Leningrad between 1967 and 1969. However, only one K-6 for Leningrad had been launched and commissioned by the beginning of 1972. That same year, K-64 experienced both cracking in its titanium hull and leaking liquefied metal flows on the exterior of the reactor, causing irreparable damage. The super submarine was decommissioned and scrapped just a few years after going on duty. After several years of tweaking, six more Alphas were finally commissioned between 1977 and 1981, with later 705K boats using a moderately more reliable BM-48 reactors. When British and American submarines first encountered the Alpha, they were astounded. The result that NATO navies located massive funding to the development of new deep-running torpedoes. During the Cold War, Soviet titanium technology was far in advance of the West, requiring fewer passes to achieve a successful weld. Successors of the Alpha class became the Surena 1 class and further improved Surena 2 class. They were also extremely expensive titanium hull boats. However, the cost of the hull limited the numbers built, despite advantages in depth, underwater speed, and resistance to damage.